Hey, she got Big Skunky. Thank y'all for coming back and tuning back in. Today, we are at the Edge Motor Museum in Memphis, Tennessee. I went to the National Civil Rights Museum. They would not let me in to film. I actually went to the Rock and Soul Museum. They wouldn't let me in to film either. Some with copyrights, and I guess they just wanna, you know, that's how they make their money. But anyway, man, look, I had no idea that this motor museum was here in Memphis. That's one of the reasons why I do the tours of Memphis, because it's a lot of things that I didn't even know was here. I don't know if you guys know, you know, but hey, it's a lot of stuff that I didn't even know that was here. So I'm gonna pause this. We're gonna go on in the inside and check out some of these cool rides. I think they got a bunch of old schools, a bunch of up-to-date cars and things like that. So look, if you're into cars, this is your video. All right, folks, we are on the inside. That's the gift shop there. We're on the inside of the Edge Motor Museum. So I'm gonna show you guys a quick picture of this wall. Let's see. The story of American Speed. I don't know if you guys can read that, but we just go down this wall. 1945, 1952. Fueling up. Oh, check this out. Look at the old radios. How old that radio is. Damn, that's a radio. I wonder if I have some people who are that old that remembers these type of radios. Oh man, it was an 8-track. That's a nice little ride there. Man, those tires are little. You couldn't find these parts for these cars if you wanted to. Here's the gas tank. Look at that. It's the gas tank. Nice little laid back ride right there. Nice little ride. Let's see if I can get on the inside. It's got a stick in the floor. Very small though. Oh man, look at the rear view mirror. The little rear view mirror up there. Let's go around and get the front of this bad boy. It's amazing how they keep these cars in this type of condition. I believe here, right here, in here they have these little kiosk machines or whatever, these little tablets, where you can tap on it and it'll give you the story about the car that we just looked at. I'm trying to keep the glare out of the camera, but unfortunately I can't control that. But yeah, it's a 1950. Doesn't say what it is as far as I can see, but you can click the gallery and things like that. Here's another one. Right here must was a race car. The inside of this car. Stand back off of it. Wonder what size engine it is. It's an Eldenbach. Is on it. I think it's a Corvette. What kind of car is that? It's a Thunderbird. Man. Man, these are some nice cars. Very, very, very nice cars. I don't know if you guys can see in the back of this one. This one actually has a back seat in it. It's a Corvette. It's a Shelby. Look at the headlights on this thing. Those are the headlights right there. It's pretty neat. The Shelby is nice too. Got the peanut butter insides. Ooh. This is the one I like right here. This is like the one that played, that was in the Fast and the Furious. Yeah, buddy. Thing is sweet. Pretty color on that car too. That's another Corvette with the T-tops in it. You see the T-tops? Well, if you get your hands on one of these cars, you got you some. It's Pontiac right here. That thing nice too. wish they had the hood open on this one. The Pontiac is nice with the rally stripes. This is a Mustang. There you go, boo boo. That's for my son. He like Mustangs. This is a 1970 Mustang. 1970. And this is a 1970 Dodge Challenger RT. That's sweet.
There's a Challenger RT.
Yeah. Drop top. Let's walk back around this way. I'm gonna explain what these other cars are too. This is a Trans Am, Pontiac Trans Am. That is a 1969 Pontiac Firebird Trans Am. And this right here, over here, is a 1969 Chevrolet Corvette Stingray. It's a Stingray. And this one here is my baby. Right here, that Skunky car. Don't nobody mess with that one. It is a 1969 Ford Talladega. And you got a 1968 Ford GT500 right here. That thing is sweet. Thing is sweet. All these cars are sweet. Okay, right here, we're just going back. This is a 1967 Chevrolet Corvette Stingray. This one here is a 1963, whatever that is. That's an ugly little car. I don't like that one. But that's the Stingray. One here is a 1955 Chevrolet Corvette. See that? And this one right here, this beauty there, that's a beauty. It's a 1957 Ford Thunderbird. Thank you, sweet man. That pearly girl right there is a 1954 Chevrolet Corvette. And this one here is a 1953 Glasspar GT. Look at that little grill on that car. That bumper got the big gangster white walls on that thing. Look at the little door. Red velvet carpet. Sweet on the inside. Let's go around and see exactly what kind of car this is, because I don't know what kind of car that is. That inside is nice though. This is what kind of car that is. It's a 1954. It's a sweet ride. Let me see if I can get a close up of that inside. popping it up. The dope slide in, look at that. But yeah, man, hey, this is a cool spot to come to, man, if you like old cars. I love old cars, man. So we're gonna walk on around to this other side. They have another side over here. I think it's supposed to be the garage or something like that. And here's the garage. So this is not a very big facility. Like, it's really not. But it's a cool place to come and check out cars, like I said. This is the garage. Sweet, sweet car. That thing is nice, man. Those bucket seats. That's a Corvette, people. This thing right here, nice too. I hate that they won't let you like walk around the cars, you know, like they have them roped off by this rope down here. You can't really get around the cars. This car here is a 1953 Studebaker Champion Starlight Coupe. So that's what the coupes used to look like. How about that? And this thing here, that's an old car too. Look at the gas tank in the front. It's pretty shabby, Chief. That is a 1929 Ford Model A Speedster. My bad, I was looking down. So yeah, man, look, for $10, you can come in, check out the little cool cars, get a little lesson on the cars, you know, when they was made, what they were made for, originally made for, and things like that, you know, it's just cool stuff to get out and do. So once again, for everybody, somebody, it's nothing to do in Memphis, it ain't nothing to do, man, look, it's a ton of stuff to do, it's just, you gotta get up and wanna get out and do it. So look, I'm gonna take some more photos. I might even film the backside of these cars as I'm walking out. They also have some cars up top as well that I did not get on my way in. So I'm gonna get those too. Yeah, look at them tailpipes coming out the back of that car. I think those are tailpipes. Yep, they are tailpipes. These are the backsides of the cars as we come out. I like them tailpipes, look at those. Unique. Now, this is the backside of all of these rats. Because we couldn't walk around to get to the backside of them. Got a glass bubble over the tag. It's got the exhaust coming out of the frame of the car. It's pretty shabby, Chief. Bad boy, he's sweet. It's a sweet ride, man. Uh-oh. It's a real, real sweet ride. Trunk little as hell. And they got the speakers in the back. They got leather in there. Hmm. excuse me. Shelby. The lights in the back of that thing. Ain't nobody inside. And here's my baby right here. Thing is sweet. I wonder why they bagged it up so far though. Well, it cost a fortune to get that back on to replace. Something's never happened to you. The Corvette with the T-tops. That thing. Man, that's a beautiful car. Let's go around. Let's go ahead and look on the inside of it. Look at that. What is that? Snake skin? Man. Yeah, they got a little compartment door over there. Look at the A-track right there. This car has 160 on the dash. Can you guys see that? 160 on the dash. That look real to me. It's pretty shabby, Chief. Look at those badass tailpipes. Old radio. Okay guys, I'm gonna have to pump up, step up the pace here. My battery's running dead. Sweet. Let's go ahead and get this one. I've been everywhere. see the flow in them. Oh, there you go. It's a sweet ride. Let's go ahead and get that one over there. What is that? It's a 2008 Tesla. Damn. Hmm, that's a Tesla. I like this Tesla better than I like the other Teslas. Yeah. It's a Tesla, people. Oh, what is this old thing over here? There goes some of those little skinny tires. I don't know what that is. What is that? I don't know. This is what they used to ride in. You was balling back then if you had one of these. The inside of this thing. This thing got three pedals. What was it, a stick or something? There goes your glove box right there. This little thing went 60 miles an hour. Can you see that? 60 miles an hour. Oh, these are lanterns. You can light the lanterns. These are lanterns. It's a damn Ford. Okay, look, my battery about to die, y'all, so I'm trying to get on up here. They have a up top area where you come, and they got all these different license plates on the wall, and you can get an overshot of the whole museum. All right, folks, I'm up top trying to get some good shots. We up top where the library part is. It's just a bunch of books and all that stuff back there. Nice little seating area up here. You can come up here and sit down. TVs, all that kind of good stuff. Bottle waters and stuff. I guess it's like their little office executive area or whatever, where they just come and have their personal meetings. But look at these old tags. I'm trying to hurry up because my battery is about to die, guys. Look how old those tags are. Yeah, these are some old ass tags, and they all expired. And anybody who know me know I got expired tags. and they, oh, my tags need to be up on this wall.
We are out, man. Look, we just left the Edge Motor Museum. Hey, man, look, this is a great place to come. If you live here in Memphis, or if you're not from Memphis and you're just passing through or touring the city, looking for something cool, laid back to do, hey, the Edge Motor Museum is the great place to come, especially if you like cars, old school cars, and you're into like Thunderbirds and Corvettes and things like that, you will love it. It's a great place to come to. It's a great place to visit. Real cool, laid back, not a lot of traffic. Admission, I think it's only like $10 to get in. You don't have to pay for parking, which is a great thing. That's great. So look, hey, till the next time we meet again, thank y'all for coming back to Skunky Farms, LLC. I'm your guy, Big Skunky. YaSmellMe.